Day 147, Circuit Schematics. Our last class we learned what was, warm-ups. What is the current through a 30-ohm resistor attached to a 24-volt battery? So we're going to use the equation V equals IR. The voltage is 24. The resistance is 30. So we are solving for the I. So we divide both sides by 30. We get 24 divided by 30 is equal to I. And reducing this down, I know that 6 goes into 24 and 6 goes into 30. That's going to be 4/5 or 0.8. 0.8 amps. We're going to skip number or letter B. And we're going to skip letter C. With a switch on, the circuit is a closed circuit. When the switch is on, that means that we've closed up any gaps, and so the charges can flow throughout. It's only when you have open air gaps in the wires where the circuit is turned off. So we call those open circuits. Anyway, here, switch on, closed. Number 9, review. A blank circuit has all the current flows through the resistors or light bulbs one after the other. That is called a series circuit. Number 10, a parallel circuit has branching wires. Today's purpose, I will learn how engineers make blueprints of circuits. Hobbyists will follow these in order to build fun circuits. We will use them in our labs. There are all sorts of projects that you can look up on YouTube and other websites like Instructables and make some really cool stuff. Burglar alarms and different kinds of activities and games and things. And you'll be given these things called schematics, these blueprints. And maybe some of you will experience that in life. Okay, so in your homework today, you're going to be seeing pictures of circuits, and you're going to have to draw these blueprints or these schematics for each one. Today's grades, homework 147, and our quiz is coming up on day 152. A schematic diagram is a type of a blueprint that shows the layout of parts of a circuit. And when you draw these things, the lines represent wires, and the wires are either going to be horizontal or vertical. Whoop, I spelled that completely wrong. Horizontal or vertical. We try not to have diagonal lines, and heaven forbid you never have squiggly lines. Even if the wire is all bent up and squiggly, you draw the lines straight. And we don't draw curvy corners, we draw nice, sharp 90-degree corners. And then we have symbols for every part of the circuit. Just like an architect for a building will have different symbols for doors and windows and outlets and ceiling fans and all of that kind of stuff, an electrical engineer will have different symbols for different kinds of light bulbs and motors and capacitors and all that. So here you can see all those different symbols. A variable resistor, that's going to be a slide or a knob that you turn. Different kinds of light bulbs might have the exact same symbol. Different kinds of batteries will have the same symbol. They might have the voltage labeled next to them. No matter what kind of a button or a switch it is, whether it's a push button or a toggle switch or a light switch on the wall, you'll have the same symbol. And you can kind of see how this looks like a knife switch with this part going up and down touching the two terminals. Speaker, buzzer, or a diode. Remember, a diode is a special kind of a resistor. It allows current to pass through one way with very little resistance, but if you try to have current go the other way, it's going to get a lot of resistance and virtually nothing's going to flow there. So variable resistors are found in things like volume controls. If you want to have the volume really loud, you have very little resistance. If you want the volume soft, you turn it so it has lots of resistance. And also light dimmers. If you want to have the lights really bright, you adjust it so it has very little resistance. Diodes are one-way streets for current. Number six, remember that in a schematic, the exact location of the items in a circuit is not important. What is important is the order that the current flows through the circuit. So when you have a blueprint for a house, it's really important that you show the door to be exactly where you want the door to be. Same thing for everything else. The builders are going to look at it and say, oh, he wants it 10 inches away from this location or whatever, and put the door there. My brother built a house, and he had his house built by other folks, and he did not have a very good architect. The architect was under some pressure, and there were some cases where the architect didn't write down or didn't draw things exactly where they wanted. For instance, they just simply showed this walk-in shower to be at one end of the bathroom, and they just put the drain symbol somewhere in the shower there, just as an indication, yeah, we want a shower pan in there. But they showed the drain to be in the wrong spot. And when the builders put it in the wrong spot, and when they got kind of chewed out by my brother for being not so smart, they just pointed to the blueprints and said, well, look, that's what they told us to do. And they put it exactly there. Okay, that kind of care is not necessary with these schematics. So when I look at this circuit here, I have an outlet going to a light switch to a couple light bulbs. I can draw the symbol for the outlet right over here just as it is. And then I draw the wire straight up, 90 degree angle, straight horizontal, and then the symbol for the switch, just like that, and then straight over, straight down, and then I have two light bulbs, like that. That would be a fine schematic, but I don't have to have the two light bulbs on the bottom. I could have the outlet, and then the knife switch, and then I could have the two light bulbs over here. In both cases, we have the outlet, and then the charges go to the switch, and then the charges hit the two light bulbs, and then it goes back to the outlet. So the order in which things happen is the same. It's just location is different, as if we turned it around this way, and so on. I could even draw it like this, where I have the outlet on top, and then the switch over here, and then a light bulb, and then way up here another light bulb. That would be a legitimate kind of a schematic as well. The order is the same. The outlet to a switch to a bulb to another bulb, no branches. Okay, letter B. I always like to start off with the power supply. You don't have to, but that's where my brain works. So I have the battery power supply, and then a wire coming out, and then a branch. So I'm going to draw two branches like that. And on the top branch, I have a button and a motor for a fan. So the button is a type of a switch. And then I have a fan, which has a motor to it. So I have a capital M. And then it comes back to where the two branches meet. On the lower branch, all I have is a light bulb. So there I have the battery, then a branch. The upper branch has two things, and the lower branch has one thing. And then it comes back together again, and everything goes through to this button. which is a type of switch, and then it goes back to the battery. Another way of drawing this is a little bit less complicated. It doesn't have this section the same. We could have the battery and then two branches this way. One has a light bulb, the other has a switch and a motor. Then it comes back together again to the battery. You can see that that is a little bit more simple looking than up here, but the parts are in the same order. Okay, letter C. Power supply is the outlet. Then we have a switch. And then we have a branch, three different branches. One, two, three. Each branch has its own light bulb. And it comes back together again to the outlet. Letter D. Power supply is a battery. And then we have a light bulb. And then we have a switch. Two speakers. And back to the battery. Next one, an outlet. Switch. A branch. Two light bulbs on one branch. No light bulb on the middle branch. And then a light bulb back to the outlet. Letter F. Two batteries in series. And then a branch. On the middle branch, we just have a switch. On the other branch, we have a light bulb, a switch, and another light bulb. And then after they come together, we have a light bulb. How do you classify circuits? This is a little bit of a review. When the switch is off, that means that it is an open circuit. There is an open gap in the buttons and switches somewhere. So if this was the knife switch, it'd be in this position like this, with an open gap, and you have wires going from here to there. Charges can flow through the wire to the knife, but they cannot jump over this open gap to the other wire, so everything shuts down. With the switch on, the switch is a closed circuit. That means that we've pushed this downwards so that it goes across like this. So now charges can flow through the wire across the knife, across a little piece of metal bridge to the other terminal, to the other wire. The gap is closed up so current can flow. Besides open and closed, are there other ways of classifying circuits? Yes, indeed. As we've said before, a series circuit is when we have all the current flowing through each resistor or light. And then a parallel circuit is one with branching wires. For numbers 11 and 12, we have items in the classroom that we would be looking at. And it's not really feasible at this time for me to show you those, and so we'll just skip numbers 11 and 12. They are not going to be on the quiz. Number 13, modern Christmas tree lights are made so that if one bulb is broken, the rest of the lights remain on. Do these utilize a parallel or a series circuit? Well, if we had a series circuit, we'd have something like this. And these are all the light bulbs, one after the other. The current has to flow through every light bulb. If we have a break in one of them, then there's going to be an open gap, and the charges are not going to be able to jump across that, and so all the current stops, and none of the light bulbs are going to turn on. So in a modern situation, we have it like this. So if this light bulb burns out and the wire on the inside of the bulb breaks, current cannot flow this way. But current will still be able to make it through this light bulb and this one and this one. And so those will still be lit up. So this is going to be a parallel circuit. And since we couldn't do question number 12 up here, we can't do number 14 down here either. We'll skip that for today.